Capricorn. Let's see what's going on for February. First, I'm going to draw an oracle card for love for Capricorn. Capricorn. Love for February. Let's see what we got. Oh, Capricorn. Oh, there it is. Well, there's two. Well, there's three. No, that's too many. Let's keep going. Capricorn. There it is. Okay. Cooperation. In your quest to manifest the energy of love, you realize that every person and experience has value. Every person and experience has value. Cooperation. So, what's going on with February? In February. In the center, judgment. I always like to see that card. Crossing that though, we have, oh, the magician, wow. Oh gosh, that's such a good combination, you guys. Underneath, four of pentacles. In the past, temperance. Above it all, the guru. Wow. Good night, guys. You guys are really up to something in February. Near future, juggling, two of pentacles. You, oh good, four of wands. Around you, Queen of Swords, okay. Hopes and Fears, Six of Cups. And outcome, Page of Swords. Some kind of news is coming. Okay, so judgment. This is an awakening. This is waking up from the dead. This is a new realization. This is a big awareness. Something, you're not the same anymore. You've become aware of something and now it's changed your life in some way. Crossed by the magician, which is a very positive card about abundance, being able to bring abundance into your life, or bring, it's the will to do and bring into your life the things that you want. Law of attraction, that's what I was trying to think of. Being able to attract into your life the things you want by taking in some sort of action. And when I say action, it doesn't have to be like a physical action. It can be an investment, the pentacles, an emotion, the cups, loving something or someone. The swords is about thinking, thoughts. And then the wands is your willpower. Just your desires, the things that you want. I feel like this new awareness, this waking up has made you realize that you have power. You're waking up to your power. You're waking up to your feeling. You're being empowered because you've woken up. You realize you have power, that you can control things, that you can make things happen. Underneath is the Four of Pentacles, which is about holding on to something. This is usually somebody who's worried about money, though. Worried about their possessions. Maybe even being a little stingy or holding on too tightly to something. Or maybe you just feel a need to protect yourself for some reason, protect something. In the near past, we have Temperance, which was about taking the middle ground, harmony. Not being too one way or the other. Sometimes it's about mixing two opposite elements together to make a better whole, to make a better outcome. I really feel like this led to this awakening. This taking the middle ground led to an awakening of some sort. And this, the guru. This is like the High Priestess card. This is being connected to your inner, to your intuition, your inner guide, your higher self, higher knowledge, a knowing. Can also be a secret that you're keeping. That might be what you're holding on to here. There's some sort of a secret. You have an awareness now of something, but you're keeping it to yourself, I feel. You're keeping something to yourself. Definitely keeping some secret to yourself. In the near future, there's balance, like having to juggle. Maybe having to juggle a situation because you're now aware of something, but you don't want to let on. And it's sort of a tricky situation. The Four of Wands, this is you. This is about, can be about a new home or starting a new home or a celebration or just feeling good because you're in a more stable situation. Or maybe you're just somebody who's all about home life. And then surrounding you is the Queen of Swords energy. This is about discernment. About being intelligent, making smart decisions. It also could be somebody around you who's protecting you. She's very protective. If this is the type of person, if she likes you, she helps you. If she doesn't, she doesn't put up with you. Hopes and fears, Six of Cups, happiness in the past, nostalgia. Maybe a hope for a return to something that was good in the past. There's a secret here. And this is a secretive card too. But this person, the Page of Swords, lets it out. Or not, or maybe not. He, right here, he's deciding whether to let the secret out or not. He knows something. You know something. You have a secret. I think you're going to hang on to it for a while, whatever it is. You know something that other people don't know. Maybe just something about yourself. That you're not quite... This is a knowing. You have a knowledge now. You know something now. Something has come into your awareness, something that you know that gives you power, some sort of power. It's empowering to you. This knowledge is empowering to you, and you're deciding when and how you're going to use it, if at all. Or you may just keep it a secret. That's kind of cool, Capricorn. Thanks for watching.